Welcome to this new Inside Code video where we will discuss a new coding problem, the longest palindrome problem. Before talking about it, know that you can activate captions and that you will find the solution code of this problem in 4 languages, Python, Java, C++, and JavaScript in the first link in the description. So have a look on it after watching the video. So what does the longest palindrome problem say? It says, given a string str made of alphabetical letters only, create a function that returns the length of the longest palindrome string that can be made from letters of str. A palindrome string is a string that we can read from the left or from the right by the same way, like the word race car for example. And here are 4 input-output examples below, so pause the video if you want to try to solve the problem. Now let's start solving this problem. First, what would be the brute force solution? The brute force solution would be to generate all the possible strings that we can make with those letters, then to start checking one by one if it's palindrome, while saving the length of the longest one you found. But this method is very inefficient, because there is a huge number of strings that we can make with n letters, and generating them all would take a lot of time. So, let's see a better one. But before, you have to know something. In this problem, we are asked to find the length, so we are not asked to make the string itself, we just need its length. Don't bother yourself trying to find the string itself, you are asked to get its length only. Focus on it, because you don't always need to build something to get one of its properties. So let's analyze this example. One of the longest palindromes we can make is this one, it has 13 letters. And we can see that in a palindrome, we have the same letters from the left and from the right. For example, here we have the letter E from both sides, we also have here the letter D from both sides, so we can deduce that to extend a palindrome string, we just have to add the same letter from both sides. For example, to extend this palindrome string, if we had let's say 2 letters F in our initial input, we could add 1 F from the left and 1 from the right, and we would get a longer palindrome string. Now let's see how did we build this longest palindrome from our input. Here are our input letters, and we have an empty string now. Remember that this work isn't necessary in the algorithm, we said that we just need the length. I'm showing this just to explain to you how did we arrive to the solution that I will show you just after. So let's take these 2 letters B and we put 1 from the left and 1 from the right. Now let's take these 4 letters C and we put 2 from the left and 2 from the right. The string is still palindrome. Let's also take these 2 letters D and we put 1 from the left and 1 from the right. And now, let's take these 4 letters E and we put 2 from the left and 2 from the right. Now we used all our pairs of letters to make this palindrome string, we can't find another pair because the remaining letters in the input are all different. But isn't there a way to extend the palindrome string more? Yes there is, it's by adding a center letter. A letter that will be in the center and it won't break the palindrome symmetry because the center letter is symmetric to itself. So we can add it safely to make a longer palindrome. Now if we wanted to describe the algorithm that I did to build that palindrome, we could say that I first counted occurrences of A, I found that we have only one occurrence, so we can't make a pair of letters. This is why I didn't use it since the beginning. Then occurrences of B, we have 3. So we can make only one pair with them by taking 2 letters of B. Then occurrences of C, we have 4, we can take them all to make 2 pairs of letters. Then occurrences of D, we have 2, so we can take them all to make 1 pair. And finally, occurrences of E, we have 4, we take them all to make 2 pairs of letters. At the end, because we have characters left, we use one of them as the center letter and we got our length. 0 plus 2 plus 4 plus 2 plus 4 plus 1 is equal to 13. So the algorithm is, we want to sort the occurrences of each letter, because we said that the input is made of alphabetical letters only. And for that, we store them in an array of 128 elements all initialized to 0, where each element occurrences of I represents the occurrences of the character whose I is the ASCII code. As a reminder, uppercase letters ASCII range goes from 65 to 90. And lowercase letter from 97 to 122. So for example, if we find an uppercase A, which has 65 as ASCII code, we will increment the element at index 65, because it represents the number of occurrences of uppercase A. So we create that array, then we iterate over letters of str, and for each letter, we increment the element at index ASCII code of that letter. Now that we have the occurrences, we create and initialize our length to 0, then we iterate over occurrences. And for each occurrences of a letter, we want to make the maximum of pairs of that letter. So we must take an even number to have an equal number from the left and from the right, and for that, we take the greatest even number that is smaller than or equal to the number of occurrences. So if the number of occurrences is even, we take it all, like we've seen with the letter E that had 4 occurrences in the example before. Else if it's odd, we take number of occurrences minus 1, like we've seen with the letter B that had 3 occurrences in the example before and we took 2 of them. After the loop, we said that if there are remaining letters, we take one of them as the center letter. And to know if there are remaining letters in the input, we just have to compare the length. So, if the length of our palindrome is smaller than the length of the input, then we didn't use all the letters, so we add 1. And we got the length of the longest palindrome that we can make with letters of str, so we just return it. To write the solution in Python, we first define the function longest palindrome that takes the string str as parameter. Then we create the array of 128 elements all initialized to 0. Then for each letter in str, we increment the element at the ASCII code of that letter. We get the ASCII code by using ord function. And note that we could also use a hash map instead of an array. After it, we create an initialized length to 0. Then for each occurrences oq of array, if oq is even, we add oq itself because we take all the letters. Else, we add oq minus 1 because we have one unused letter that couldn't be used to form another pair of letters. After the loop, we compare the lengths, and if the length of the palindrome is smaller than the length of str, we add 1, the center letter. Now we just need to return the length and we finished our task. For the time complexity of this algorithm, it's O of n, where n represents the length of str because we are just iterating over the n characters of str, and the length of occurrences array is constant, 128, so it doesn't increase the complexity. And for the space complexity, it's O of 1, because even if we use an extra array of 128 elements, it is still considered as constant, because the concept of constant space complexity is not that we don't use extra space, it just means that the amount of extra space we use is constant. In other words, it doesn't get affected by the input size, which is the case here, because we will always have an array of 128 elements no matter the input length. And speaking of time and space complexity, I'm happy to tell you that the next Sunday, April 19th, 2020, I'll release a free course on algorithm analysis on insidecode.tech. It will have a theoretical part where I will introduce and explain concepts as time complexity, space complexity, complexity different cases and values, amortized complexity, etc. And a practical part where there will be solved and explained practice questions to strengthen your knowledge. So see you next week on insidecode.tech, and if you are watching this video after April 19th, you will find the link in the description of this video. Go check it, and don't forget to have a look on the code of this solution that is available in 4 programming languages in the first link in the description. I hope that you understood this solution, and see you in the next video.